right now.
It's been one day since the former city manager of 15 years, Richard Morton Greenwood. The former city manager of 15 years, Richard Morton, was removed from his position. We hear from the man who will have to step in and take his place.
Also, Desert Fire and Rescue unveiling their new fleet this evening. How the $8.2 million fleet will help first responders better serve the community.
And how a coffee shop in Greenwood is helping students develop important life skills outside of the classroom.
Live from Midland, Odessa, and Big Spring, we're Basin Frosted, Basin Proud. This is Local 2 News at 10 in HD.
Good Wednesday evening, everyone. I'm Horace Brown.
And I'm Katie Orth. It's great to have you with us for Local 2 News at 10. In your top story tonight, an update on Tuesday night's Odessa City Council meeting where now former city manager Richard Morton was fired. Local 2's Caleb Calvano caught up with the mayor and the deputy city manager who talked about the future of different downtown projects. Caleb.
Guys, Richard Morton served as the city manager for Odessa nearly 15 years, but after last night's city has been fired, causing uproar in parts of the Odessa community. Voted in. Manager Michael Marrero says that everything is going to be fine.
We have 900 employees that are dedicated to their job, who are willing to do what it takes to make sure that this city succeeds. You know, I've worked in the city for 20 years. I love what I do, and I am prepared to serve in whatever capacity the city council wants me to serve.
Now, we have reached out to former city manager Morton. However, he's declined to make any comments on the situation. Reporting in the studio, Caleb Calvano, Local 2 News.
Good information, Caleb. Thank you. A routine traffic stop in Odessa leading to the arrest of a felon. Police found this man, 32-year-old Tony Tucker of Odessa, very nervous when he was questioned during a traffic stop near 31st and Walnut. According to police, Tucker was so nervous when they asked for his driver's license, he handed over his cell phone. That's when officers became suspicious. They searched his vehicle and found a loaded gun.
The driver had a knife on his lap. The officer observed a live round on the floor door next to the driver's seat, and the driver was also found to be in possession of a loaded gun. And Tucker was determined to be a convicted felon, and he was also found to be in possession of approximately 10 grams of methamphetamine.
Tucker has been charged with the manufacture or delivery of methamphetamine and unlawful possession of a firearm by a felon. Reports show he also has a criminal history of sex offender charge with indecent exposure.
Now, the officer who made the arrest was Corporal Sean Aloftian. He was named Officer of the Month today, along with Sergeant Caleb Lacey, Corporal Chris Mice, and Corporal Jonathan Campbell. All four were sent by OPD to the Houston area to aid in hurricane relief efforts. We spoke with two of the officers who spent almost a week helping police in Harris and Fortin County.
We looked at it as a once-in-a-career opportunity. We took a trailer, and we had enough supplies to sustain us for 10 days. And when we got there, we didn't need anything. There were people dropping stuff off left and right. It was unbelievable.
We even made the joke that we'd come back home 10 pounds heavier. We were so well fed while we were there.
The four joined hundreds of officers from around the state who spent time helping Houston area police patrol disaster zones.
Sticking with OPD, the department's honor guard in Houston earlier today showing support for fallen Houston police Sergeant Steve Perez.
Sergeant Perez drowned a couple of weeks ago after his patrol car was caught in floodwaters in the aftermath of Hurricane Harvey. Our thoughts and prayers are with the Houston Police Department at this time. Now at 10, the Midland County Republican Women welcoming two special guest speakers at their monthly luncheon. The organization hosted Representative Tom Craddock and Representative from the Texas Public Policy Foundation earlier today. Representative Craddock gave an overview of the bills that were passed in the special session and spoke on several issues currently affecting the state.
It's a great opportunity to hear about issues that affect our state, to hear about from candidates, to hear about upcoming elections, to hear about things that are affecting our city, our state, our community.
Members meet on the second Wednesday of every month.
Odessa Fire and Rescue welcoming the community to an unveiling of their new fleet this evening. It's the existing
equipment that are
up on fires. This is the second military vehicle the department converted to meet their needs. Governor Education News, a local PAC holding a town hall meeting this evening to discuss the upcoming ECISD school bond election. The Four Kids Future Steering Committee bringing citizens together for a presentation and to facilitate an open discussion of the bond election. The committee will be holding a number of town halls over the next 2 to 3 weeks to make sure the community is informed going into the November elections.
The public needs to be able to make educated information that they
need to ask questions from the people that will be responsible for the use of the money going into the bond.
Well, new at 5, a new coffee shop being run out of the old middle school office in Greenwood is changing the lives of some local students. Now, the coffee shop not only serves hot chocolate and a hot cup of joe, but a healthy dose of life skills for special needs kids might just be the best thing on the menu.
I want each of our one day to be able to hold a job and get a job. Everyone can work, so we want to learn job skills.
Now, the goal of the coffee shop is to help kids learn real life skills by greeting the customers, running the register, serving coffee, and stocking shelves. Now, the shop opens from 8 to 8:45 Monday through Thursday.
I'd like a cup of coffee for them.
I think it'd be fantastic. All right, 2028 can't come soon enough for Los Angeles.
That's right. Coming up, LA.